Aloha from Hawaii. My name is Ian Van Tuyl, and behind me is the 2008 Hanse 540e. This is a new listing that I just took. We're currently in Oahu, Hawaii, and let me give you a little tour around this vessel and show you some of the features and benefits that it has to offer. So as I mentioned, this is the 2008 Hanse 540e. This vessel has been fully equipped to do offshore passage making and cruising. What's really unique about the 540e is the transom here will actually lower down, and you'll see from some of my pictures how large this compartment truly is, that you can stow a dinghy in, and it gives you a really nice platform to board the vessel while you're on a mooring, on the hook, or what have you. But the nice transom itself is really flush, and it has a boarding ladder centrally located that'll drop down, so you can get easy access to that. As we walk up forward, you're gonna see we have a beautiful blue hull. We have a bottom paint that was just done recently, and that's white. The Hanse itself has a really nice large freeboard, keeping you dry and safe on offshore passages. As we walk up forward, you can see the nice ports throughout the hull and a really flush plumb bow. There's a really unique anchor system that I have in some of the pictures that you can see, but the anchor system will fold on out. Hanse is really known for its self-tacking head sail. So you have the track here for the self-tacker, but you also have a track here on the side deck for a Genoa. As we walk up into the board of the vessel, you're going to notice also this has all been upgraded. This is really high-end stainless lifeline gates that the owner has upgraded for offshore passaging. We have a bimini, a connector, and then a dodger with a stainless steel grab handle. The main sheet system is quite neat, so there's no track itself, but what happens is this gets led back into the cockpit. There is a teak cockpit coach roof and teak decks. All of the hatches have coverings, so it really protects all of the overhead hatches. And as we walk up forward, there is a very large sail locker. There's multiple sails that come with it, and in the listing presentation, I talk about the different sails. So as we walk up here, you're gonna see just how beautiful and how flush this bow truly is. And then opening up the anchor locker, this is the folding anchor roller system. So what you end up doing is stepping on this lever, lifting up on this, and this will fold up into place. And then you can see we have a nice Lumar windlass, large anchor locker up here, and then our propane stowage in there as well. So there's also a plug that you can control the windlass from up here, so it's quite nice. The other thing I want to point out is this is an upgrade from the factory. We have the folding cleats. So in the up position, this is what they look like. And then when you want them completely out of the way, they fold right down into the hull. Really nice. You have an attachment point for a spinnaker pole here. You have lots of really cool rigging. And this particular rigging is set up for a preventer. The preventer line gets led back to the cockpit, so you can control the boom preventer from the cockpit, and also it allows you to do multiple different things as well. All the halyards and sheets get led back into the cockpit. Once again, this particular owner has set this vessel up for offshore cruising, so he's upgraded all the halyards and sheets to Spectra, and a really nice upgrade. The other thing that I want to point out to you is the rigging itself. This is diform standing rigging. You can tell by the flat edges on this. This gives you the strength of rod rigging, and it is a really superb standing rigging. This is a force bar carbon fiber spinnaker pole, so you can have this set up in multiple different functions, from on the deck or on the track here as we see. We also have adjusters, so it allows you to adjust that spinnaker pole on the track. About a year ago, the owner has put all new electronics with the radar. There's a TV antenna, there are LED spreader lights, we have a nice mainsail lazy bag system, you know, making it very easy to drop the sail and stow it. As we walk back into the cockpit, you're going to notice that all of the clutches and everything is really good access to the helmsman. You have a really nice aft deck back here. And as you can see, this particular owner has beanbag chairs back here to lounge out on. We have an adjustable backstay, really nice structure for the bimini system. Just up forward, we have our carbon wheels. This is a true carbon fiber wheel. The owner's done a really nice upgrade with a texture on the top of them. We have a new Yanmar engine display panel here. Our Lumar electric windlass, our windlass control here for the winch. Our bow thruster, this is a retractable bow thruster. And so it really gives you a nice speed with having a really nice flush bottom for that bow thruster control. But pretty much what you do, you turn on the unit, you lower the unit down, and then you'll have full control over it. As I mentioned, newer electronics. So this is our autopilot and a multi-repeater here. Great area for all of our sheets and halyards to be stowed in. Centrally located is the new Simrad NSS 12. This is a 12-inch display, really nice unit, state-of-the-art. Just below that is a compass. At the port helm, you're going to notice that we have a emergency bilge pump, our speakers. We have our Simrad speaker controller here, 12-volt outlet, our Fusion stereo remote, and then also a new Simrad remote mic for the VHF. So really nice access to all of these controls. The Simrad second autopilot display, and then we have two multi-repeaters here. But as I mentioned, everything gets led back into the cockpit. Really nice high-end Spectra running rigging. Very high-end and very well done. We have a nice cockpit table here, and as we walk up forward, you can see the nice seating with a high backrest, giving a real comfortable feel offshore. As we come down below the vessel, you're going to have four steps that gradually get you down into the salon of the vessel. The salon is quite stunning. Very, very open, high ceiling. So if you're looking for something with great headroom, the 540E definitely provides that for you. Our galley's off to the starboard side, which we have a freezer compartment, a side loading and top loading refrigerator, a really nice three burner stove and oven, Corian countertops, and a beautiful woodwork found throughout with cabinetry found. We have a molded sink, so the sink itself is sectioned into two different parts with a really nice European style faucet, stainless steel hand grab rails. Directly across from us is the nav station. The nav station is set up quite nice, lots of upgrades that have been done throughout the electrical and what have you. We have a multi-repeater. Down here we have our Wasabo diesel heating system as well. So if you plan on going north or in colder climates, this vessel's set up for it. The Fusion stereo CD DVD player, and then you also have your Fusion iPod iPhone docking station here. The Iridium sat phone controller, and then the Blue Seas systems monitor. So this is a full systems monitor system for the electrical, which is really nice. We have bilge idiot lights here. This is set up for all the different bilge pumps found through in the yacht, throughout the bottom of the vessel on the different compartments. The electrical system is set up here. We have our generator controls, and then AIS. We also have AIS built into the VHF as well. Everything is also integrated with a iPad. So this is all set up, seeing exactly where we are. So when you're at the lower nav station or down below the vessel, you don't need a dedicated plotter for that. You can just take the iPod or iPad anywhere you go. As we look up forward, you're gonna see we have beautiful white leather sofa interior. The floors and the combination of that cherry just really stand out. Lots of cabinetry, stowage. We have Bose speakers for full surround sound with a Bose subwoofer. A very nice large flat screen television here mounted on the bulkhead. And then as we walk up forward to the forward V-berth, you're going to notice lots of hanging locker stowage. We have a little desk vanity area here. There's also air conditioning and heating controls found in the master stateroom, salon, and two aft cabins. but remarkable. Really well done. Beautiful. We have a walk-in shower here. So this is our shower fixtures. So this is a really nice system that you're going to find here. Tecma electric quiet flush toilets. Once again, beautiful European style faucets, and just how they molded this all in is quite stunning. Lots of opening compartments here with mirrors and what have you. Looking back after the centerline queen berth, you have great access on both sides, so you can, you know, peel out of the bed which way or the other without disturbing the other person. We have two ports, two overhead opening hatches, and then our third opening hatch just above the storage cabinets here. As we walk back aft, you're going to see we have two staterooms aft. These are both twin identical staterooms. We're going to be coming into the aft port stateroom, and this has a queen size bed, and it also has an area where you can remove the center so you can make it two single berths. Lots of hanging locker storage, cabinets, you know, found throughout, great lighting, and then each cabin has its own private head and shower. There are also the Tecma quiet flush toilets with beautiful, you know, molded countertops, great fixtures, lighting and mirrors found throughout. We have engine access in this stateroom as well. Our generator, our engine, and then also from the companionway steps, you have access to the engine. So with a simple lift, this lifts up with gas shocks, and you have full access to your Fisher Panda generator and your Yanmar 110 horsepower diesel engine. This also has the upgraded Balmar alternator on it.
Well, I hope you found this video to be helpful and informative. If you want more information about the